Hi there, welcome to the new lecture on setting up your enrollment for Windows devices. So when we talk about enrolling Windows devices, you have three different options, my friends. The way we enroll is actually have different options you have. So since you are the Intune administrator, you need to set up Windows devices to enroll. But now the question comes, how do you set it up? Do you want to, you know, go for complete automatic enrollment? Then this is the first option that you have here. So the first option, which talks about automated enrollment, that's an automatic enrollment option, which can be configured from Microsoft Intune portal or Mem Admin Console portal. But this requires a premium license, which is close to $6 per user. So that is actually Azure AD Premium license. So you also need to have Intune license as well as the AD Premium license to configure this. By the way, where we can configure this? So let me show you something here. If I just go to the devices, I have a Windows by platform. I have a Windows enrollment. I've been always, you know, try to say that, you know, you could always go and learn by platform. Right, you can always go and learn by platform. If you don't want to go to the by platform for enrollment option, you also have here enrollment options, which is same. So you just have to click on the Windows enrollment. That also points to the same thing, but I like to go this way because we're just talking about the Windows section now. So within Windows enrollment, you have an option called automatic enrollment. Now if you look at here, this is where you could actually configure automatic enrollment. So the option itself, it says that this is automatic enrollment. So this can be configured in case if you have a Azure AD P1 license. How can you check it? You can simply pick up any of the user randomly. For example, in my case, Alex. So this guy has a license of a product called EMS specific, this is. So if you see here, Azure AD Premium P2 is there, as well as a P1 is there. So in my case, at least I need to have Azure Active Directory Premium 1 license, then the enrollment can be completely automated. Otherwise, the enrollment doesn't work. Okay, my friends? So the enrollment doesn't work. So think that, let's say you have full credit of, you know, as your P1 license, then you would simply enable for everyone. But let's say you're actually doing some kind of, you know, project work, then definitely you would be, you know, assigning to a specific group. For example, I'm currently testing for my sales department. Example, I might be, you know, just choosing here my sales department specific. For example, here digital initiative, public relations, I can only choose it. So it all depends on, you know, what company or what kind of, you know, group you want to, you know, target as a first pilot users. So in case if you're doing a project work, you might be, you know, scoping for only test users. Later point you would, you know, scope for everyone. So when you say here all, there are two things needs to be done. One is Azure AD P1 license to be there for automated enrollment. Let's say you don't have a P1 license, still that's okay. I'm gonna, you know, tell you the other option, but you need to have at least Intune license. If you don't have an Intune license, then the users cannot enroll the devices into Microsoft Intune portal. Okay, so that's the first thing. And also a lot of people gets confused with what exactly this MDM user scope and MAM user scope. So let's say MAM is basically focused on bring your own devices concept, my friends. Let's say you have some kind of application that you wanted to define and you wanted to apply some kind of application production policies without enrolling properly, but you want to manage that applications with the help of Windows Information Protection or WIP. That's another product altogether, and then you would be, you know, configuring. So let's say if I configure all and also configure all, which one will be, you know, taking as a precedence? So the coming back to the preference for a bring your own device, that's a personally owned devices, always MAM takes a preference. That's why the default setting is always none. And Microsoft says that, you know, go for this, not with the MAM. But you know, there are some kind of, you know, situations you might have to also work with MAM, to be frank with you. Okay, now let's say I enable here all, so I can save this configuration. This is how you can, you know, configure the first configuration for Windows enrollment options called automatic enrollment. That's it. So we have completed the first option, which also required a Azure AD Premium. So let's say I don't have a premium license. Do I have any option? Yes, my friends. You also have another option. Let's see, you need to go to settings. For example, I'm just trying to show you know how you're gonna enroll, right? So when you try to enroll here, like, you know, you need to, you know, click on enroll only in my example device management example. I'm just trying to say, so post to this, it actually asks for the URLs to be entered by manually user. So let's say you don't have a premium license, the user have to point to a proper URLs to be given, then only the enrollment can be done. So just to avoid that, because think that, you know, from an end user point of view, we don't tell our entire end users to, you know, hey, please enter the URL, the specific URL, so that this device can be enrolled into Intune. I don't want to say that, right? So what I can do is I can configure something called a CNAME registration. This is an option two for the users who do not have a Azure AD Premium. So how can I configure that? CNAME is a canonical name, right? CNAME here, basically, if you just go to this link, you get the more information how to configure. But you know, CNAME is a canonical name, which is coming from your DNS. So you could also do that again from devices, for Windows devices, from a Windows enrollment. You have an option here, CNAME validation. Let's say I'm actually using in this case a domain called memcos.com example. So just test this. So it is gonna validate that the CNAME record is found for this, because I did create it, my friends. Okay, let's say what kind of record to be created. Let me show you that for you. You basically have to add these things. Let's say you have a company name called maybe Contoso example. So what you have to do is you have to use your enterprise enrollment dot your company name dot com. So in this case, Contoso.com here, and that should be pointed to this specific URL. Remember, my friends, here it is ending with enterprise enrollment hyphen s. So this is very important. Everywhere it is pointing to hyphen s. If in case if you're referring to the old documentation, you might not see hyphen s, which is no more supported. Okay, so that is the one of the important tricky point as part of the troubleshooting. And let's say you have two companies. How do you know login? Let's say, you know, I have a user called user at contoso.com example, and also I also have another user called maybe in this case user at the rate maybe company abc dot contoso.com example. If I have a two dots in between, I need to create multiple entries also. I mean, when I say multiple, if you have a multiple dots that is on your domain, for example here, if you see here us.contoso.com or europe.eu.contoso.com, then you need to create for each of this so that the users can enroll in an easy way. So these things need to be created in your DNS. So let me show you that also. I have this domain which I bought it from Namecheap. So let me know, show you from a domain list. I should, you know, go to my advanced DNS and simply go back to the DNS records. So in this you can see here two records which are pointing with the configuration to enterprise. If you see here memconsole dot, this is the enterprise enrollment dot my domain name dot com. Similarly, I also have enterprise registration dot mem course.com. And you could see here, this is actually pointing to the Microsoft Intune portal for registering. Otherwise, the user have to enter this manually. And if you have these things, it's good and more than enough for you to proceed further. That's why the CNAME test is successful. Now you know what's happening here. So let's one more time. If I test it, it is working. That's it. There's nothing will be current here, done kind of button. Simply close this, so it's working fine. So what we have done so far, we try to configure automatic enrollment, which can be enrolled if a user have a P1 license as well as the Intune license, and also you have configured also CNAME validation. This is the second option for users who do not have a P1 license. That's Azure AD P1 license. They can also enroll as a normal. There is nothing to be done. But if you have still a question, if I set this automatic enrollment to off, can I enroll the devices by configuring CNAME? No, that's not possible. So you must have to scope here the configuration for your MDM configuration to either some or all based on your project scope, and then you need to know validate your CNAME as well as this. So that's how you have to do it. So this is a very important point, right? So now I know that 2 points I've covered. Now let's have a look on very interesting configuration which we're going to talk about it. I'm pretty sure this was never discussed in my channel or maybe in others channel much, but this is a very tricky part. So there's something called a enable bulk enrollment. So if you just go visit this specific URL, you get more documentation on that. But if you see here, it actually requires this bulk enrollment requires the Azure AD Premium, and there's a specific tool that also very very important and it is needed. The tool name Windows Configuration Designer. So this is a tool, WCD in short, Windows Configuration Designer. This is a tool that actually needed. So how the tool looks like and where can I get it, these questions you might definitely get it, right? So this tool is available in Microsoft Store documentation. So you just go to the Microsoft Store and you can buy it's a free, no need to pay for anything, but you simply get it download from there. So how it looks like once I installed, so when you open it looks like this. So what are the things I can do it with this tool? You could actually create a configuration PPKG file. That's a double PKG file. What it does is basically during the wizard, when you open up from Microsoft Store, then you have this option, you can create a provisioning desktop, provisioning Windows mobile devices, Surface Hub or HoloLens or kiosk devices, advanced provisioning with a lot of configuration can be done manually. So these are the options will be there when you open that tool. If I want to make another video on that, yes, definitely I'm going to make that video, and it should be available in the description of this video wherever you're watching. But in general, I cannot club this entire tool in this video because the motto will change, because that itself a dedicated video needed for explaining. But just to explain here, high end with the low level configuration steps is very important to understand. So that's what I'm gonna explain here. So when you open this, it actually runs with a wizard kind of thing, where if you just click on, for example, provisioning desktop, it actually asks, hey, do you want to put your computer name with some kind of serial name on the computer name or some kind of a naming standard? Then you could enter what is a product key. For example, you received your device as a Windows professional when you receive from your hardware vendor, you want to upgrade it, hey, I can do it for you, something like that. It does all that configurations for you, including your Wi-Fi automation. Your certificates can be pushed here. You can even install some kind of applications if you know the application IDs, application names, and you could push your certificates. You could create even account management, account information also. So like this, if it gives you very in detailed information. If you see here, once you completed that, this wizard actually it generates kind of, you know, complete details settings. Let's say I wanna configure my language, maybe a Japanese language, or maybe Chinese language, or maybe a French, for example. So these things also I could, you know, configure by using this specific tool called WCD or Windows Configuration Designer. Once you've done every configuration, you could, you know, actually, you know, expand here to, you know, get more information, which I'm going to cover in the next video. But once you have configured everything, assume, then you could actually export it. So once you export, you could, you know, save it. Now, how would I use that package? That's a question, right? So now I have a couple of questions. So a couple of options, I would say, not the question. So the thing is, like here, let's say you have an existing device, you want to do the reset. So when you click on reset this PC, it asks, as part of the reset process, hey, do you have, do you want to know recover from, or do you want to install it basically from a media? That kind of, you know, option will come up, right? So when you choose that option, inside that media, you can put this PPKG file, right? Then automatically during the Uber experience, like, you know, the selection of the keyboard, all of that stuff, it actually does that automation and it configures the settings that you are actually keeping for provisioning that specific device. That's option one, right? Option two is, let's say, if you just go to maybe settings and accounts and access work or school account, then you have an option here. If you see here, provisioning packages, right? You could actually add here, meaning this is the second option which I'm talking. Post the machine is ready, that means the machine is ready, user have to be, you know, provision a configuration settings automatically, the things that you have already created here as part of your provisioning package. Then you simply, you know, add the package from here, show the package, it does that. Hey, do I also have any other option? Yes, my friend, that's a third option. I didn't actually named here 1, 2, 3s, but you know, you could see the third option is you could actually deploy this with Intune. So you also have the PPKG packages also can be deployed from Microsoft Intune as a provisioning package. So since this is a bigger thing, I would be definitely covering in another video, but just, you know, give you these are the options that you have with the enrollment. So three different options, but most of them will be using the first option. So the budget low companies will be using the CNAME registration option also. So they would, you know, go for 192 but not for the three, because this also have some kind of, you know, limitations. You could, you know, read more information from the specific URL which I'm going to give you in the description of this video. I hope I made it very easy for you. Of course, I didn't talk about the bring your own device or maybe a corporate device. Yes, my friends, that you could, you know, always enroll with all of these options. You can enroll your Windows devices with bring your own device. That's a personally owned device as well as the company owned devices concept can be applied. Further, check out the other lectures that are in this description of the video. Thank you for watching this. We'll catch you in the next lecture.